Hello students, I want to welcome class 8 for this online classes. How are you all students? I hope you all are doing good in your home. Shall we start our computer science class? Are you all ready? So which chapter we are going through now? Yes, we are studying chapter 7, Introduction to Graphics, Part 1, Section 15. Do you all remember last time what chapter we have gone through? Chapter 6, Program Execution in C. And this class we are going to start with a new chapter, that is Introduction to Graphics. Shall we have a quick recap what we have studied? Yes. Shall we have a quick recap what we have done? Yes. We studied about input statement. Input statement, output statement, program execution, steps for the execution of program, sample program, and output. These are the things that we have studied in the previous class. And what are the topics that we are going to discuss? Yes, we are going to discuss the topics. About introduction, types of graphics, vector graphics, image file format, meta image file format, and Photoshop. These are the things that we are going to discuss in this class. I want everyone to pay attention as we go through this class. As we study each point, I want everyone to pay your attention in this video. Okay, shall we start students? Are you all ready with the class? Yes. The first topic we are going to study is introduction. It's very important in the lesson. Okay, we are going to study about graphics. How many of you are interested in art? I know that many students are very interested in art, doing art, different kinds of art. Okay, in your paper, immediately when someone says that you draw for me this, yes, we take interest. Though we are not interested in doing drawing and all, but still we feel like doing something, okay, some kind of art in the paper. We feel like drawing lines or doing coloring work and all. Many children likes that. So art is anything that is drawn on the paper. Okay, and this art is generated or drawn on a computer with the help of some special software called digital art or graphics. Okay, and what are they, students? Again, I will repeat this. Art is anything that is drawn on the paper, and this art is generated or drawn on a computer with the help of some special software called digital art or graphics. Graphic images are used in many ways. Many ways we can use the graphic images. Okay, and also we used in many ways. We surround ourselves with graphics at home. On wallpapers, curtains, computer games, cartoons, dresses, labels, on products, magazines, etc. We like to do all these things. Yes or no, students? Yes. We surround ourselves with the graphics anywhere. Sometimes we see on the road, we feel like drawing something, or we see good art on the wallpapers, curtains, different kinds of stylish curtains we see in our house, okay, or when we go to shops and all we see, and computer games. Very much interested to play computer games. If we get chance, we will never lose it. Okay, cartoons. Till now, we are crazy about cartoons, watching cartoons. Okay, not only children, but even big people, old people, everybody likes to watch cartoons. Dresses, we feel like wearing different dresses with different styles, and graphic pictures are placed on the dresses and all. Labels, on products, magazines, etc. We see graphics everywhere and we see lot of arts everywhere, okay, throughout our life, wherever we see, wherever we go. Yes, there are many different graphic packages available, each allowing images to be saved using different formats. Some of the packages are listed below. The first one is, okay, the first one is Adobe Photoshop. Okay, second one, Illustrator, Adobe Illustrator and Corel Drawing. Okay, these are the three important packages that are listed below. Okay, now next we are going to move to types of graphics. Types of graphics. There are number of different types of graphics, file formats, and each storing graphic data in a different way. The most commonly used file formats are bitmap. Okay, the most commonly used file formats are bitmap, vector, and metafile formats. These are the three important commonly used file formats, okay, in the graphics. Okay, the first one we are going to study is bitmap image file format. Bitmap image file format. A bitmap image is made up of lots of tiny dots or pixels of various colors. And these tiny dots join together to form images. And this file format is used to store bitmap data. And the best example for bitmap image is Paint in Windows. Okay, Paint in a Windows operating system. The file formats for bitmap, okay, graphics are very important, students. These are file formats for bitmap graphics are GIF, JPEG, TIFF, BMP, PNG and PEX. Okay, I will clearly tell you what exactly these things are talking about. Okay, I want you to pay attention in this, children. Okay, we have two different formats. Okay, these are the two different format. Okay, one is format and one is description. Okay, format GIF. What is GIF? GIF, these are the expand the following that we are studying, students. Please pay attention. GIF, graphic interchange format. JPEG, joint photographic expert groups. TIFF, tagged image file format. BMP, Windows bitmap. PEX, personal PCX, personal computer exchange. And PNG, portable network graphics. So these are the six formats and descriptions. Okay, format, these are the expand the following, we can say that. Okay, and please remember, keep these things in your mind, students. When I ask you, you should be able to answer to this immediately. So when you start watching this video, you should keep this in your mind. Okay, next we are moving to vector graphic image file format. Vector graphic image file format. This file format is used for storing line-based elements like lines and polygons. Vector graphics are based on the vectors which lead through locations called control points. Each of these points have a definite position on the X and Y axis. Okay, it has a definite position on the X and Y axis on the work plane. The coordinates of these images are saved as mathematical data, and the images can be filled, copied or moved individually and pasted over each other. okay, pasted over each other. And the commonly used file formats are for vector graphics, okay, are AutoCAD, DXF, Drawing Exchange File Format. Okay, the DXF means Drawing Exchange File Format, and Microsoft, okay, SYLK, that means symbolic link. Okay, SYLK means symbolic link. This is the full form of that. Okay, and then we are moving to meta image file format. Meta image file format. Okay, what does exactly the meta image file format say, students? Can anyone guess what it talks about? Yes, it is used to store both bitmap and vector information in a single file. Okay, it stores in a single file, and the file format is both device and machine independent. It is used to transfer images from one hardware platform to another. Okay, students, please keep this in mind. It is also used to transfer images from one hardware to platform to another. Okay, WPG, one word perfect graphic format. CGM, full form, computer graphics and meta format. And PICT, picture, okay, and a Macintosh OS are the commonly used meta file formats. Now let us learn about Photoshop. Let us learn about Photoshop deeply. Okay, it is an important tool, students. It is an important tool for graphic designers and professionals who work on these images. Okay, this is mostly important tool for graphic designers and they who are very professional about this work and images. Okay. Okay, Photoshop. What is Photoshop? Can anyone has an idea regarding this, students? Photoshop? Yes, Photoshop is nothing but an image. Okay, it is nothing but an image editing software developed and manufactured, okay, by Adobe Systems. It allows the user to manipulate, control, for example, cropping, resizing, color, digital images. These are the things we all know very well, right? Cropping and all, resizing and all, and color, digital images. We know we use all these things in the WhatsApp or Facebook or whatever it is. Okay, and this software is popular among professional photographers and graphic designers. We will now discuss deeply in Adobe Photoshop. Okay, Adobe Photoshop in this chapter. Okay, so getting into Photoshop. How to get into Photoshop? How do we operate this? First, we should know that. How should we operate this? We should know this first step. Okay, step one. First, we need to click start. Step two, all programs will appear. Step three, Adobe Photo. You can see the picture over there. The document will appear. Okay, and step four. Okay, step four, Adobe Photoshop. Okay, CS6 in this chapter will appear. Okay, now the full, you can see the picture over there. All this document will appear over there. This is called an application window. Okay, Adobe Photoshop CS6 application window. Okay, in that we see option bar, menu bar, we see panel set, we see toolbars, we see status bar, we see work area, we see, okay, and menu bar. These are the things that we see in the total application window program. Okay, students, I hope you all have understood what all we have discussed till now. Okay, please go through the video again and again. Open your textbook. Whatever I said in this video, please follow according to that. Okay, now Shall we have a new words what we have studied in this lesson? Shall we study that? Go through that new words, students. I want you to keep it in your mind. Remember these words. Okay, we have studied in this lesson some new words I'm going to discuss with you. Okay, first one, generated. Generated, G-E-N-E-R-A-T-E-D, generated. Second one, vector, V-E-C-T-O-R, vector. And meta, M-E-T-A, meta. Format, F-O-R-M-A-T, format. And graphics, G-R-A-P-H-I-C-S, graphics. Interchange, I-N-T-E-R-C-H-A-N-G-E, interchange. Windows, W-I-N-D-O-W-S, windows. So students, please copy these hard words in your classwork. Okay, put a new chapter 7, introduction to graphics, and write their spellings. Okay, new words. And write all these new words in that notebook. Okay, when I tell you to show me, immediately you should show me that new words. I want all of you to follow this, okay, and copy it in your notebook. Now, we have studied the expand the following, okay, in meta image file formats. Here, clearly I wanted to show to you all. The first one we studied is WPG, that is Word Perfect Graphic Format, CGM, Computer Graphics Meta Format, and PICT is Picture in Macintosh OS. And these are the three commonly used meta file formats. We should keep it in our mind. Okay, students. So I hope you all will follow this too, students. Pay attention to this video. Okay, go through this video carefully, watch it. I want everyone to watch the video and know what is there in the video. Then only you will understand about the lesson. Thank you all, students. Take care. I'll see you all in the next class. Till then, bye.